Hey guys, welcome back. Today we're gonna do this painting here. Yeah, we start by mixing the palette for the first layer of color. You can see here we have seven colors. I'm using here a HDF plate. And I have to oil out the painting surface with some linseed oil to prevent the color from getting sucked in too quick. But I do it first on the upper end and very basic, two different colors for the sky, more or less, a darker one and a lighter one. And to prevent the colors from mixing into the part where I will put on the watercolor later on, I use some mask tape and fill up the sky area, level it out with a very soft blender brush, and start with the application of the first layer of color for the water area, making sure that the line is not too sharp. Just using a brush to refine it, to kind of blend it a bit between the color of the sky and the color of the water. We have these darker areas in the back and the a bit more greenish, lighter ones in the front. You will see later on that this color was a bit too light. I had to rework it, kind of, in the next step. But as a first layer, it was, worked pretty well. If you'd like to see the full-time version of this video here, check out the Patreon link here. Over 5 hours of pure painting. Of this painting surface, it's not a real canvas, it's a pressed wood, more or less, with a very even surface. And I prefer this one for the fine water details over the canvas structure. Now I'm grabbing a set of brushes here, as you can see, small rounds, small flats. Then I mix another set of colors. I let the whole thing dry, really bone dry. Make really sure it's completely dry, not just a bit dry, but completely dry. Yeah, and then I build up those rocks in the front area. When I start to do it, it looks kind of off, bit weird, but I'm just starting to build up those rock details. Basically, what we do here is we have a thin layer of water in the lower end, and this layer of water gets thicker and thicker the more you come to the upper part of the painting. And this needs to be reflected by letting those rocks fade out in the upper end, but to also make sure that those rocks in the foreground are also a bit blended, so that we don't have any we need to do this water perspective, and this is done by making those edges very blended. The rocks in the foreground currently are not yet in the state where I would like to have them. So I'm going back and start to soften down the edges a bit more. And then I let kind of fade out the dark color in the upper end into the into the dry first layer of color. You see I'm blending the edges a bit more. It looked just too edgy, and therefore I go back and blur up those rocks in the front part. And I'm also kind of trying to hint those rocks in the back part, as you can see here. I'm going back, using this dark color to kind of shape rocks out of the background color. It's a very convenient technique to really build it up this way. I'm getting in the color thinner, leaving out some areas of the background color to hint those rocks that are kind of getting more and more blurry when it comes to the water that becomes thicker and thicker on this area here. And here I'm already establishing the line of the wave. We have the dark area kind of beneath those areas here, And yeah, then I'm mixing this blue color and start to build up those reflections from the sky that we have here. It looks currently completely off and weird and strange, but yeah, you have seen the final painting. It will start to look really nice when you build up those waves, those reflections very carefully by dry brushing, letting the color fade out and into the still dry background color. And I basically just adjust the thickness of the color here and there. And the thicker I go, the less the color of the background comes into play. It's a very easy technique of just not having to mix 55,000 colors. I'm kind of just having one color here and kind of toying around with the thickness of it. And then I start to build up on the still wet color that I applied here. Those sparkles, I think the most important elements here on a water painting. Without them it looks off. It wouldn't look like water, it would look like a blanket or something. But those little sparkles, those little reflections, kind of make this thing start to look realistic. Building up those things is, you have to rely on the reference photo a lot, I think. Those things are reflected, or the sunlight is reflected in special areas, and this to mock it up out of the straight imagination is a very difficult process, I think. I'm showing you how I rework those colors. I started to build up those waves, and I really realized that it is just too light. Not menacing enough, not dark enough. And so I mix this darker color here and start to build up other wave details, other areas where we have water, a bit thinner, a bit thicker, reflection wise, and also changing a bit the colors, getting a bit more brownish, a bit more greenish in there, but really trying to build up those kind of mountains that we have, and with this dry brush glazing technique we can very easily shift those colors and change them for the better. And you see the technique is very simple, basically a very tiny amount of color on the brush and rubbing it into the surface. And this is what I said before, I'm using this very flat HDF plate here to paint on, so that we don't have any structure of the canvas interfering. This is a very for me a very easy process, but for newbie painters, really make sure you use just a tiny bit of color on your brush. This is another set of brushes that we're gonna use for the next layer, and really again make sure this color, this layer of color that we applied now, is completely bone dry. Here I'm grabbing some linseed oil and start mix some again the same color for the reflections of the sky that we have here now to put in. And again with a very careful approach, really carefully trying to build up those areas very slowly, toying around with the thickness of the color, really making sure that I follow the line of the water. Basically, you have to imagine it this way. Those bluish colors here that I apply now are basically the parts of the water where those water parts have a certain angle towards the sky. And this is basically all that I hint here. Kind of building up those areas where the light is bouncing off into the viewer's eye. in this way that we, yeah, kind of hint those little, yeah, mountains of waves that we have here. Those little, kind of mountains, more or less. When you imagine the water is not moving here, I mean, of course it's not. It's a painting. We are slowly building up kind of little mountains, more or less. And the more we come towards the horizon, the thinner or the flatter those mountains become. And this kind of hints this distance in this painting here that we have here. I'm using a flat brush here. I'm holding it very horizontal towards the horizon line. I mean, it's not a trick, but it's obvious that you can do it this way much easier than with a flat with a round brush. Basically, you have one brush stroke and you have basically kind of one wave, more or less. And then I go back, grab a very small round brush here and start to build up those reflections here, those sparkles on the water. And it's so amazing to see that from looking like a blanket again, kind of thing, it really starts soon to look like real water. You see a detailed shot of how I'm kind of blurring some of those reflections here to make them really kind of blurred a bit. It's not just dots. It's kind of blurred areas where those sparkles kind of fade out, more or less. And you also see that I'm again here on the right side a bit darker, have more of these shadow areas in the water. But I'm still trying to give the whole thing shape and volume by adding those hints of color here and there. You know, again, a detailed shot of those sparkles and those reflections. And I think these are, I said this before, but these are really, I think, the key part to this whole thing. One of the key parts, and of course, on the foreground, we have also this foam parts that I'm also already starting to put in here. And we have this wave breaking here. Basically, I have this blue color here put on. Then we have this dark area here, where the water is very thick and curvy. We don't see any reflections of those, of the sky, more or less. And then we have these foamy parts in the front, this rushing water here that I'm hinting. Same goes for here. We have this foam parts, this whitewater parts here. I mean, it's not a real whitewater that we usually have on the front parts of a wave directly on the beach. It's a wave that breaks a bit further out. And now the most important part of this thing is that you also need to add those sparkles, those reflections on this area of the breaking water wave, where we have kind of the light bouncing off into the viewer's eye in the right angle. And this is this really starts to make this painting look realistic. And it's kind of getting in this darker colors first, again with this dry brush blending technique, and then adding this foam parts, this whitewater parts, and then I'm on top of that adding this nearly pure titanium white dots, sparkles, and so on in all different kinds of shapes and sizes and directions. Kind of dry brushing them on here and there. Then I go back, add some more titanium white to even add more sparkle, more highlights in some areas here and there. Yeah, and then the last step was to rework the sky part. It just didn't look right, just too flat in my opinion. And then I just mix a light blue color and start to dry brush it onto the still, yeah, still try background color by just adding some clouds here and there to just spice it up a little bit. Very easy, very straightforward, very quick way of building up some parts here, some cloud details. Yeah, that's the finished painting. Yeah, that's it for today. Make sure you hit that subscribe button, that like button, and see you next time. Bye.